In this tutorial, I want to lay the groundwork for all of my tutorials by giving you an overview of Fusion 360's latest user interface. I've added several important details and a few tricks that weren't included in the original version. Be sure to stick around until the very end of this video, as I'll be showing you two pro tricks that almost all beginners wish they had known earlier. The Fusion 360 user interface can be broken down into 9 main sections. For your convenience, I've also outlined all of these sections on my website, so you can reference them as needed. You'll find them at productdesignonline.com/26. That's productdesignonline.com/26. When you log into Fusion 360 for the first time, you'll start with a blank project. The first thing you'll see in the top left corner is the application bar. Within the application bar, there are 4 key areas. First, you can access the data panel, which houses your design files. The next item is the file menu, which lets you create, export, or share your designs. You can then save your designs or select the undo and redo buttons to revert your most recent actions. Across the top, you'll also see the tabs which represent each design file. Each tab will display a file name and the version number. However, if you have a large number of files open, then you'll only be able to see the name on hover. This works in a similar manner to the tabs in your web browser. Let's talk about the data panel a bit more, as this can be treated as the second key component of the interface. If you toggle open the data panel, you'll see that you can create new projects. You can then create new folders within each project to further organize your design files. The data panel also allows you to manage other users who are collaborating on your projects, but note that there are restrictions based on which license type you're using. Anytime that you're coming back to the data panel to open a project, you'll simply need to double-click on the file or right-click and select the Open option. In the upper right-hand corner, you'll see the User Profile and Help section, which is the third main element of the Fusion 360 interface. It's here where you can view your job status, Fusion 360 update statuses, and online/offline statuses. Under your username will be a handful of account settings and preferences. As you continue to learn Fusion 360, you'll want to familiarize yourself with the default preferences, and you can change them to better suit your workflow. To the right of your username is the help icon, which gives you quick access to the forums and helpful troubleshooting articles. Next, you'll see the main toolbar. The toolbar allows you to select what type of workspace you would like to work in. It's important to note that the tools on the toolbar will differ in each workspace. Within each toolbar, there are also tabs, which further organize the tools into logical groupings. As you start to discover your own common workflows, you can customize and rearrange your toolbar features. Next, you'll see the Fusion 360 browser. But first, before we discuss the browser, let me know what types of projects you're learning Fusion 360 for. Comment 3D printing, woodworking, or other down below in the comments. The browser lists objects in your design, including planes, sketches, parts, assemblies, and so on. You can think of the browser as your file structure. Within the browser, you can change the visibility of objects, as well as change your document units. Let's now talk about the ViewCube, or the 3D cube in the upper right-hand corner. The ViewCube allows you to orbit your design or view the design from standard view positions. You can either select faces, corners, or arrows, or you can simply click and drag the ViewCube around. You can also hit the home icon, which is next to the ViewCube, to view the model in the default home position. The middle section of Fusion 360 is where you'll be doing sketching and all of your design work. Therefore, this section is referred to as the canvas. Within the canvas, you can access the marking menu, which is also referred to as the right-click menu. If you right-click, you'll see frequently used commands along with the ability to change workspaces without having to go to the upper left-hand corner. To fully utilize the marking menu, you'll want to memorize the position of these features at the top. The marking menu intends to give users the ability to right-click and drag at the same time towards the feature that you want to quickly access. For example, I'll right-click and drag towards 2 o'clock to activate the press-pull command. The second-to-last section is the navigation bar and display settings. The navigation bar contains commands used to zoom, pan, and orbit your design. These will give you a little bit more control than the use of the ViewCube. On the other hand, the display settings control the appearance of the interface. It's right here that you can turn on and off the ground shadows and other effects, turn grids on or off, or view your design from multiple views at once. Last but not least, we have the timeline at the bottom. The timeline lists the order of operations performed on your design. Double-click on timeline features to quickly edit their properties. You can also right-click on operations to make additional changes. Because Fusion 360 is a parametric modeling program, you can also drag the operations around to change the order they are calculated. However, you'll want to be careful, as changing the order can also cause errors or problems with your model. You've now made it through all 9 of the key sections of Fusion 360. To reward you, I want to share 2 pro tricks that are always overlooked by beginners. First is the ability to set your home position to the desired view. If you're working on a more in-depth project, such as this bike frame, then you may find yourself wanting to set the home position to the area you're currently working on. To set the home position, you'll first want to orient the model to the desired view. Then, simply click the caret toggle next to the view cube. You'll need to select Set Current View as Home, and then you can choose either Fixed Distance or Fit to View. The Fixed Distance will set the view to how your model appears in the canvas, whereas the Fit to View option will ensure your entire model is within the view. If I now change the view and select the Home icon, you'll see it reverts to the new home position. This can save you a ton of time as you're modeling, especially when working on more in-depth projects. You can also reset the home position back to the standard isometric view. The second pro tip is with the grid that you see while working in Fusion 360. By default, the grid is adaptive. Now, this means when you zoom in and out, your grid spacing will change accordingly. There may be a time where you're designing a product or object based on a grid or set of increments. If that is the case, then you can set the grid to stay fixed to a specified increment. Select the Grids and Snaps option at the bottom. We'll then have to select Set Increments, and we'll have to switch this to the Fixed option. You can then define the increments of your grid, and these will no longer change based on your view. As always, I truly appreciate you taking the time to watch this tutorial. Click that thumbs up icon if you learned something in this video. To be part of the Product Design Online community, be sure to subscribe and check us out on Patreon by clicking that Patreon logo right now.